This is Nas watching JR Sports Brief. Life is good.
So just like Nas said right there, life is good. It's Fan Friday. It's all about you all and your comments. I am tired as hell. We all know the Miami Heat won Game 7 last night. LeBron picked up his second ring. Make sure you subscribe to JR Sport Brief right here on YouTube. You will not miss a damn thing. We all know a lot of questions that I've already answered in videos, people are asking. So go ahead and subscribe. Don't miss nothing like the video I posted yesterday. But we're not going to waste any time. We're going into the first question. That man Marcus on Twitter. Will the Miami Heat repeat? And another similar question from Always Triller, straight out of Oakland. What's up to everybody out in the Bay Area? I was out there about a month ago. What team will contend the most with the Heat for next season? Well, first of all, any team with LeBron James has the opportunity and the ability to compete. I don't care if Chris Bosh is there. I don't care if Dwayne Wade's knees still work. I don't care if they still have Juwan Howard holding a clipboard on that bench. Any team with LeBron is going to be capable of competing. And when it boils down to what teams will probably give the Heat a run next season, it's a little early to be worrying about that. We all know we still have to deal with the draft. We have to deal with free agency. But you have to think about teams that are built around stars. What will Derrick Rose do next season with the Chicago Bulls if he's healthy? Will they have a secondary score for him? Because Luol Deng, I don't necessarily think he's going to get the job done. And then you have other big-time stars and guys like Kevin Durant. You have Russell Westbrook. Let's see how he competes when he's healthy. What about the Los Angeles Lakers? Will Dwight Howard end up there? And then you also have to think about where Kevin Garnett and Doc Rivers go. That just seems like an ongoing soap opera. So when you want to think about next season, think about big stars. But any team with LeBron James, they're going to be capable of competing. Moving on to the next question for Fan Friday. It seems all anybody wants to talk about is basketball, but this comes in via Eddie Reyes asking me about the Patriots. Arrest warrant for Aaron Hernandez. Is this guy guilty or not guilty? Obstruction of justice. Look, when you start like wiping your house down, when you start destroying cell phones, when you start getting rid of surveillance footage, there's a good chance that your ass is involved. And I know some people that know Aaron Hernandez personally. They went to school with the guy, and people have always told me that this guy isn't the smartest dude on the block. And who can forget his stupid little stripper make it rain dance celebration? I think he better watch doing that, especially if he ends up in jail. So the Patriots, in my opinion, they're in trouble. Who the hell is gonna catch the ball? Danny Amendola, always hurt. Rob Gronkowski, always hurt. I guess he injures himself in the titty bar. And then you have a guy who may be connected to a murder. So I don't know about Tim Tebow at tight end. People are talking about that. But have you ever seen a guy catch a football? He can damn near barely throw one. That's Fan Friday. And a big shout out to Brian Corpaz on Twitter. It's his birthday. Happy birthday to you. As you get older, life will suck. And then we also have a congratulations to Montepaschi Siena. They won their seventh straight Italian League championship. I got a lot of friends out there. You guys need to bring me over for vacation. I'm dead ass serious about that. This is JR. Make sure you subscribe right here on YouTube. Hit me up on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram. Life is good if you're a Heat fan, not if you're a Spurs fan, not if you're Ginobili or Tim Duncan, or Tony Parker, Patty Mills. Maybe his ass will relax now. Make sure you subscribe. I'm out, folks. Peace.